most incredible leopard behavior. That skydiving is just insane. Just a really special thing to witness.
And it's about to enter the kill box. My heart is pounding.
In the heart of the Okavango Delta in Botswana, big cats are apex predators. Patient, precise, and lethal, these cats will do whatever it takes to bring home a meal.
I really like to compare African big cats to Olympians. So leopards are more like the gymnasts of the big cat world. They are jumping from trees onto their unsuspecting prey.
Just patience, patience, patience. And it looks like it might finally pay off.
I have a feeling this is going to kick off.
Jumped. The question is, has she got it? I think she has.
Although, even the best laid traps need a bit of luck.
Oh, she failed. She just missed. Oh, unlucky, my girl, unlucky.
All leopards have adapted completely different to where they are. Our leopards are aerial hunters, which is very unique and very interesting.
Most incredible leopard behavior and something she does so well. That skydiving is just insane. You get to see her jump, spread out, ready for impact is just a really special thing to witness.
But leopards are really adaptable and will find hunting opportunities everywhere.
Leopards are solitary animals. When they hunt, they'll be completely alone. They take advantage, they'll try to hide in the bushes.
This behavior is so leopard. She's basically just sneaking along the floor, super quiet, very agile. And just trying to, you know, predict what the impalas are going to do next so she can get ahead of them.
They are great observers. They're able to stay incredibly hidden and lost in the foliage, and they spend a lot of time sitting, watching, absorbing.
They are the ultimate ambush predator, completely camouflaged in the savanna grassland.
They stalk to a position. They very seldom stalk right to the animal. They'll stalk within proximity and then wait for the animal to actually walk onto them.
And then you'll see leopards switch from this amazing ambush predator to almost kind of being a hybrid between a lion and a cheetah. You'll see them just gap it across floodplains the second they see something because they know they can outpace it and they can outrun it.
The Michael Jordan of cats. Slam dunk.
If leopards are like Michael Jordan,
lions would be the weightlifters. When they're hunting prey, they are like bulldozers going in and just bringing prey down.
You need experienced lions, you need the biggest and strongest and the heaviest to bring down these big animals.
Lions work collaboratively with their pride to attack prey from all angles, divide and conquer.
The matriarchs have got years, years and years of experience.
When one lioness gets up and signifies that she has identified a prey item that they can go for, they all sort of understand the role that they play in that scenario.
On the darkest of nights, when there's no moon, the lions are invisible. They can walk up to prey species that are 2 or 3 meters away and they really don't know that the lions are there. You know, it's about sealing the deal. It's about getting that extra few meters. That's the difficult part.
And for that, you need a game plan.
This is a strategic hunt where they will work together. So you've got some lionesses heading out on the flanks and others setting up as a center.
They are setting a trap.
That lioness has gone all the way around the other side of the lake tree.
The whole idea is that the flanking lioness will drive towards those who are sitting in ambush. So it's fascinating. Each individual lioness has a preferred role in these hunts.
The lionesses on the flank push the prey into the waiting jaws of the rest of the pride.
And she is in a perfect position now. So if she moves in towards them, she'll startle those lechwe, push the lechwe back towards all of the other lions are waiting. It's really clever.
But the cubs have other ideas.
Very much their instincts taking control. Lechwe everywhere, lions everywhere, but nobody got anywhere near a lechwe. You can tell the cubs don't really know what they're doing, but they're certainly trying.
Lions have to use their heads more than their legs when it comes to catching lechwe.
Despite being masters of the night, lions succeed in less than a third of hunt attempts. But another cat in the Delta has a significantly higher success rate, and they're highly specialized to achieve it.
If I had one word to describe a cheetah hunting, it would be pizzazz. They have so much pizzazz when they're hunting, not only with their speed, but also their techniques when they're moving.
She's a slight cat. She's built for speed, not for strength, really.
Cheetahs have long legs, allowing for big strides up to 7 meters. They can cover a lot of ground and fast. They also have large nostrils for increased oxygen intake when sprinting, and distinctive tear marks underneath their eyes.
Well, what's nice about the tear marks is it doesn't just look beautiful, it actually also helps deflect the sunlight off of their face while they're hunting.
Aside from sheer speed, cheetahs also rely on their incredible camouflage.
Cheetah spots help with the cheetah in disrupting its shape. So if you look out into the open, if the cheetah was just one color, it'll be a lot easier to see it moving throughout the savanna. Now with the spots, that breaks it up.
This type of camouflage is called disruptive coloration. The spots break up the outline of the cheetah, so it blends in with the vegetation.
The Okavango Delta has a considerable amount of trees, vegetation. Cheetahs use this to advantage. They always want the prey to be upwind from them so that the prey cannot get their scent.
What she then does is she runs through the tree line and she just flushes the impala out. They all go flying, they scarper off in different directions. She then just uses her speed to chase down an impala.
Cheetahs are the fastest sprinters in the animal kingdom, reaching up to 100 kilometers per hour.
My adrenaline is going through the roof. What? She's just nailed an impala. Oh my word, that's wild, yes. Yes, yes, come on.
Big cats are all really different, and I guess that's why this area is so interesting, because there are so many different hunting techniques that are in play in the same place, yet they all work extraordinarily well.
Thanks for watching. For more big cat action, head to the PBS app or pbs.org to watch Big Cats 24/7. The series follows African big cats around the clock over 6 exhilarating months. Check out the link in the description to watch the show.